Hi students, so today there is a new chapter 2, whole numbers, and you already learned about natural numbers and whole numbers in the introduction of chapter 1. So no wasting of time, let us introduce in very short time. Whole numbers start with 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So collection of 0 and natural numbers is called a whole numbers, set of whole numbers. So you know, every numbers we get adding 1, that is called the successor. If 1 add in 0, we get 1, 1 add in 2, 1, we get 2. 1 add in 2, we get 3. 1 add in 3, we get 4, and so on. And this is the number lines. Number line also explained in chapter 4, but this is only for the whole numbers. Every right side number is always greater than the left side numbers. And whole numbers start from the 0. So, what is the successor of 0? 1. Successor of 1 is 2, successor of 2 is 3, successor of 3 is 4. And same as the precessor of 4 is 3, precessor of 3 is 2, precessor of 2 is 1, and precessor of 1 is 0. But there is no precessor of 0 in whole numbers. Okay? So, if you have a book, then you check in your book. If there is no book, so listen only. In the previous chapter, we have studied counting numbers, natural numbers. In great detail, every natural number has a successor. The successor of 1 is 2, the successor of 2 is 3, etc. Also, every natural number except 1 has a precessor. 1 has no precessor in natural numbers. To collection of the natural numbers, we add 0. As the precessor of 1, the natural numbers along with 0 form the collection of whole numbers. In this chapter, we shall study whole numbers and their properties. So, you observe the properties here. All natural numbers are whole numbers. All natural numbers, these are natural numbers, are whole numbers. But all whole numbers except 0. Are natural numbers, or you can say all whole numbers are not natural numbers. Okay, so 1 is the smallest natural number and 0 is the smallest whole number, but there is no greater number in whole number and natural number. If anybody asks you what is the greatest natural number, you say that is infinity. What is the greatest whole number, you also say that is infinity. So whole numbers can be represented on a number line. So you watch the number lines here, and the distance between two consecutive whole numbers is taken as one unit distance. One unit distance. The distance between 2 and 4. So how much? That is 2 unit, 1 unit and 2 unit, and so on. One out of any two whole numbers, the number on the right of the other is the greater. This further is implies that this is also addition on number line. So addition of number line, how we addition a number line, you also learn in previous classes. Suppose that is 2 plus 3. So addition in number line, 2 plus 3. So how we add 2 plus 3? So first we start from, what is this? 2. So this is the, how much add with 3? That is 1, 2 and 3 column. So how much? That is the total 5. That is the 5, that is 3 and that is 2. So this is the addition of whole number. And so now, practice exercise 2.1. you observing here, and 2.1 exercise. It's very simple exercise. Exercise 2.1, question number 1. Write first 5 whole numbers. First 5 whole numbers. So first 5 whole numbers. Whole numbers start from 0. Okay. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is a 5 whole numbers. First 5 whole numbers. Part B, first 5 natural numbers. So you know, first 5 natural numbers. First 5 natural numbers. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 are the first 5 natural numbers. Question number 2. Write the successor of 39. Question number 2. Successor of 39. How is successor? So plus 1 you get, that is 40. So successor of 31, 39 is 40. Preceder, question number 3, sorry, question number, this is the 2 and question number 3, preceder of 57. So how we find the preceder? Subtracting 1, you get 58. So these all things you already learned in class 5th, how to find the preceder and how to find the successor. You find the successor plus 1 and preceder minus 1. Next question, write all whole numbers between 87 and 92. 87 and 92, whole numbers between them. So you can write the counting from 87, that is 88, 80. 9, 90, 91. These are the whole numbers between 87 and 92. So remaining questions, you observe them and try to solve them. If you have any problem, then you ask me from my contact number, that is 9140016733. This is also my WhatsApp number. You can ask me personally if you have any query. Thank you. Shut your mouth. Sorry, not for you. It is my son. So, students, this is your exercise. So pause the video and note the questions and try to solve this exercise. Again, I am saying, if you have any problem, then ask me or give in numbers. Thank you. So students, next topic is properties of whole numbers. When we look into various operations on whole numbers closely, we find several properties of whole numbers. These properties are quite helpful in understanding number better and also in making calculation very simple. In this section, we shall study about various properties of whole numbers. The first property is closure property, and this property you already learned in first chapter, natural numbers. So again we learn the closure property in whole numbers. So here we examine if the whole numbers are close and under addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. 3 plus 4 equal to 7, a whole numbers. 9 minus 3, 6 is equal to a whole number. 3 into 4, 12, 12 also a whole number. 9 divided by 3, 3 is also a
whole numbers. But check here, 2 is divided by 4 is equal to not a whole number. So you whole number, this is also here 2 minus 3, not a whole number, a whole number. See what addition and multiplication. So what? From the above, we find the whole number are closed under addition and multiplication only. Addition and multiplication. Because in subtraction, there is a problem. And division, there is a false. Because we not get the complete whole numbers. And this we get the minus 1. Minus 1 is not a whole numbers. So, closure property applied only in addition and multiplication. Commutative property. Here we examine which two whole numbers can be added, subtracted, multiplied, divided in either order. So first, 3 plus 6 or 6 plus 3. You add any order, you get the 9. 3 minus 6 and 6 minus 3, this is not. Because 3 minus 6, you get minus 3. And 6 minus 3, you get 3. So they are not same. But in multiplication, 3 into 6, you get 18. And 6 into 3, you also get 18. In division, 3 divided 6, not same as 6 divided into 3. So, what? Commutative property is only applied in addition and multiplication. So, you can check here. Next, associative property. Associative properties. First, are two sums, 8 plus bracket 4 plus 3. So, you add them and check. 4 plus 3 is 7. 7 and 8, 15. 8 and 4, 12. 12, 3, 15. Both are equal. And check the multiplication. 4 into 3, 12. 12, 8, 96. 8, 4, 32. 32, 3, also 96. Yes. In each sum is 15 and each product is 97. What difference do you notice in two sum in two produce product? The difference is only in grouping of three numbers. If you are asked to add three numbers, is which is easier and why? Simplify them. So thus the addition and multiplication both are associative for the whole numbers. But subtraction and division are not with associative property. So examples are given. Find the sum of suitable arrangement. 837 plus 208 plus 363. So let's check. First, 837 we take outside of the bracket plus 208 plus 363. Add them by the commutative property. And add them by associative property, we get 1408. And same as example B, and there is a multiplication also. So I hope you can solve the given questions. So exercise is also given. Some notes are given here. A whole number is never divided by 0. When a whole number is divided by 1, the result obtained is the whole number is itself. 12 divided by 1, we get 12. 30 divided by 1, we get 30. When 0 is divided by any number, the result obtained is 0. So, notice here, a whole number is never divided by 0. If any number divided by 0, it is not defined. 0 is divide any whole numbers, we get the 0. So next exercise is 2.2. Subtraction is not closed for whole numbers. Write any two different pair of whole numbers to justify the above. So I hope you justify like 5 and 6. So 5 minus 6 is equal to minus 1, and 6 minus 5, you get 1. So let us solve, or visually I solve this exercise. First you try it, later on I solve this exercise. Okay, thank you.